This is a presentation all about group work, showing the shift in the learning environment that can be created by group work when students are working together in the classroom environment. Group work is really what creates an active and dynamic learning environment where students are doing three different things. Not only are they showing knowledge, knowing that's an activity that resides in the practices that are shared by the people, but they're also doing in the classroom. They're practicing or showing what they've learned, or they're acquiring their learning through the act of physically accomplishing a task or showing a skill. But also, group work creates this dynamic environment where students interact in a state of being. This is when a person's interests, their motivations, emotional commitments, and personal and social values really come out in the classroom environment. This is how students have an opportunity to show who they are, what they're interested in, that identifies that person as a person and shows really what they value. Group work creates this active and dynamic environment where students can show their state of knowing, doing, and being. So why should we be doing group work in the classroom? Well, it's because student peer interaction promotes better initial thinking or better initial learning, better retention of the content, and better reasoning skills. In general, when students are allowed to work together, when they're allowed to talk, to process their thoughts, to get other people's ideas, over time, what research has shown is that students actually develop this ability to initially learn at an increased rate than students who work in isolation. They actually can retain content that's taught to them in the classroom for longer periods of time, and they also develop these reasoning skills, this general sense of intelligence, because they're allowed to bounce ideas off of one another, because they are allowed to gain different perspectives from other students. According to Resnick, Asterhan, Clark, and Shantz, students had opportunities who had opportunities to debate their ideas, learned more, retained more, and overall sometimes even outscored their peers in comparison when peers were not allowed to work together in groups. When students are allowed to use their own language as a tool for learning, it shows how their thoughts and their language can actually be related to each other. When language is used in the classroom, it helps students develop these critical thinking skills. And thought and language are merged only in the context of group work in the classroom. If a student is not allowed to think out loud, if they're not given opportunity to say what they're thinking, they will not internalize the learning as well as they could if they have a chance to verbally process the content. Group work also creates this idea of dialogic learning. So, dialogic learning is when students take that cognitive ability and they think out loud about some problem that's going on, questioning some kind of surprise finding, or articulating an explanation, or reflecting on their own reasoning. This is a serious shift from the previous or long-standing culture of teaching, classroom teaching, where teachers were just looking for students to give the right answer. What we valued previously in the classroom in our education was students learning how to give the correct answer to a problem rather than allowing them to struggle through something and really develop this critical thinking skill of inquiring for their learning. What dialogic learning also does is it gives students an opportunity to do more than just memorize facts. It actively engages students within the content rather than just asking them to sit there passively and receive everything that the teacher has to say. Group work creates then a greater access to learning. What this does is it minimizes the achievement gap. It provides a greater access to the learning tasks to more students in the classroom and gives a wide range of academic skills and linguistic proficiency to more students. Again, because group work requires more conceptual thinking rather than just memorizing facts, this gives students a greater access to learning across the board and closes achievement gaps between high and low students. This also is a shift between student-centered, or what has previously been teacher-centered, classroom instruction, and now shifting to student-centered classroom instruction. Group work really creates this community environment where children and adults are working together in a structured environment, rather than just the teacher owning all of the content, all of the information, and passively the students are receiving it. Now in group work, students are participating and they are the management of their own learning because they are involved in the process. All of these things work together to be a part of what creates